Moonlight. I am so, so sorry. Moonlight is directed by Barry Jenkins, and it was the 2016 Academy Award winner for Best Picture in the surprising upset over the front runner La La Land. And Moonlight is the tender, heartbreaking story of a young man's struggle to find himself, told across three defining chapters in his life as he experiences the ecstasy, pain, and beauty of falling in love while grappling with his own sexuality. So like I said, Moonlight, while it was an acclaimed film, it beat out La La Land for Best Picture in the surprise upset. In fact, I remember La La Land was originally announced as Best Picture, but a screw-up happened, and they read the wrong envelope, and it turned out to be really embarrassing when they read the wrong envelope for the wrong movie. And so when Moonlight turned out to be the true winner, a lot of people were shocked. Even I was shocked. I had never seen Moonlight at the time, and this is actually my first viewing of the film, by the way. I alluded to this when I talked about the film briefly, when I talked about Beale Street in my vlog video, which I'll leave a link down below if you hadn't seen that video. I posted a rant about my feelings about this win without having actually seen the film, and that was a decision I deeply regret. In fact, here's words I actually said on Letterboxd 2 years ago over this matter. I said, 100 years from now, when most of us are dead and gone, I have a gut feeling that La La Land will withstand the test of time better, mainly because it doesn't rely on politics to tell its story. La La Land is an inspiring look at longing to fulfill your lifelong passion, something that past, present, and future generations long to dream. I mean, La La Land was my favorite movie of that year. It still is, even to this day. That was such a great return to form for movie musicals, and it's easily one of my top musicals of all time. But people got upset with me, because I had specifically said in that post that I hadn't seen Moonlight. There were some people that thought I was being a little prejudiced because of the subject matter involved in Moonlight. So one of my responses to one of the comments, I said this: don't think me as racist or anything, but I feel like the Academy simply chose Moonlight as a political stunt to apologize for the Oscar So White controversy the year before. It may be a great movie, which I hope it is, but I still think La La Land has the bigger fan base and will hold up better in the years to come. So essentially, without judging the film for myself, I thought Moonlight, based on my notions of the Academy, only picked Moonlight because of the fact that it had an all-black cast, and it was they just chose it as a consolation prize to make up for the Oscar So White controversy. For a while, I thought it was going to be an overrated movie, and that was why I had put off seeing the film for a while. The only reason I decided to finally see the film was because a couple weeks ago, I saw Barry Jenkins' latest film, If Beale Street Could Talk, did a vlog video on that, and I promised in that video I would do Moonlight for my review videos for Best Picture winners on my channel. So here we are, Moonlight. So what did I think of the film? Well, it is not overrated. And I don't think the Academy chose Moonlight for Best Picture just because it was a political stunt to make up for the Oscars So Right. And obviously there's some gay themes throughout the film. And I thought the other reason I thought they chose it is to, you endorse LGBT rights. It's not a political stunt. In fact, I don't think this is an Oscar bait movie that pushes a specific political agenda. It feels like a real movie, and that's one thing I have to compliment Barry Jenkins on, but for both this and Beale Street, the film tackles heavy issues, but I don't feel like I'm being force-fed somebody's ideals and agendas down my throat. With both these two films, it feels like Barry is taking these heavy issues, but focuses on the characters and how grounded they are. And I think in that regards, you gotta respect him for doing stuff like that. And like with Beale Street, Moonlight is a phenomenal looking film. The cinematography just pops in every single shot. And this is a grittier looking film than Beale Street was, since it's set in like the ghettos in Miami. So there's a lot of darker colors this go around, but the film is still very striking. And every shot in this film, like in Beale Street, you can take a snapshot of it and put it on a postcard, because it's definitely quality filmmaking. As alluded to earlier, Moonlight tackles several different issues, some of the poverty in a lot of African-American communities, and it also focuses on the struggle of homosexual black kids, as they tend to get frowned upon in a lot of these ghettos. It shows the everyday struggles without coming off as pretentious, preachy, or agenda-pushing. Like I said, the main character of it feels like a real grounded character and all the three aspects of his life that they focus on, from him as a kid in the first third of the film to him being a teenager in the middle and an adult in the end. All three aspects of the film are just as grounded and just as compelling to watch. I don't know if it struck emotionally with me like, you know, the romance in Beale Street, but I enjoyed seeing this character's progression and where he goes in the maturity of the character. And even the filmmaking structure of the film is really cool. It definitely feels like a three-act structure, and there's like different chapter transitions between each segment, so it kind of feels like a book come to life. So let's talk about Chiron for a minute, because he's played by three different actors. All of them do a good job, and it feels like when you watch the film, you forget it's three different actors. You feel like it feels like the same person in different phases. So that was really neat. And like I said, I admired the realism of the character. They could have easily scapegoated the kid because they were grappling with sexuality, and it's like, look, there's the gay kid. You gotta sympathize with him because he may be gay. But I never saw that. I just saw a kid struggling to fit in and figuring out what he wants to do in his life. And seeing a grounded character unfold at the side of the spectrum or lifestyle, if your character is written very well, I will definitely pay attention. And the cast alone is also great as well. Besides the Best Picture win, and the film also won for its adapted screenplay, Mahershala Ali won Best Supporting Actor. He's only in the first third of the film, but he's definitely the standout of the film. He's this mentor character that helps Chiron out because he lived in a really bad home. Wow, but he has demons to fight of his own. And just the nuance of Ali's character is really phenomenal. I really liked his performance. Another underrated performance is Naomie Harris as Chiron's mother. She can get very sadistic at times because she's a character that's addicted to drugs. She's an underrated actress. It's definitely a performance people forget about because they look at all the three actors that played the main character and Mahershala Ali, but they forget about Naomie Harris. And I thought she was really good too. As mentioned earlier, I don't think Moonlight hits me emotionally compared to some of the other nominees. I still prefer La La Land, by the way, because I think I related to the characters more in that film compared to the characters in Moonlight. But I can't deny that Moonlight is a beautifully crafted film. It's definitely well shot and directed all around. Really distinct music score. And the fact that the movie tackles, you know, heavy issues without feeling preachy or phoned in, it should be commended for that. That alone, I'm glad Moonlight did win, even though it was my personal pick. At the end of the day, I'm going to give Moonlight an 87 out of 100, the equivalent of 4.5 out of 5 stars. Again, Moonlight, I am so, so sorry for judging you before seeing the film for myself. Good movie. Really good movie. That was my review of Moonlight, the first of the Best Picture winners I'm tackling in the month of February. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please let me know down in the comments below what you thought of Moonlight. Did you love it? Did you hate it? But please be civil and respectful of others' opinions. Definitely don't be prejudiced. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Click the subscribe button to see more content and click the little bell next to it to be notified of future videos. If you haven't subscribed to me already, I tend to do movie reviews, TV reviews, and trailer reactions, and some other fun stuff along the way. So if you look at the stuff I've already done, you might find something to enjoy since there's a good mix of stuff already. I definitely have some more videos coming for you soon. Definitely look forward to more Best Picture winners. Some videos I plan on doing on the contemporary winners side, which my definition of contemporary is post-1980. So those include Braveheart and The Hurt Locker. So definitely look forward to those two as well. Also, we'll do some classic Best Picture winners as well, because to fulfill my goal of doing at least two classic films a month. I hope you have an amazing day, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye!